Professor L. Kwan Hung of Health Psychology and Primary Care Psychology from Vijay University at Brazil called this global lockdown due to COVID-19 perhaps to be the largest psychological experiment ever that humans are undergoing. Is the COVID-19 lockdown our self-induced psychological experiment? The answer in all probability is yes. My name is Arunita. I'm a PhD student and science communicator. And in this video, I will be telling you why and how this might affect us. In early March this year, when COVID-19 was declared a pandemic by the World Health Organization, some countries had already sealed their international borders and had imposed domestic lockdowns, and the declaration encouraged others to follow suit. The imperceptible nature of this disease, the high transmission rate, and no cure or antidote being available at the moment, well, the lockdowns were the best we could do. Business Insider has estimated that 1/3 of the world population is facing mobility restrictions and is under some kind of a lockdown right now. That makes 2.6 billion people. And out of these 2.6 billion, 1.3 million are in India. India is leading the list in the size of lockdowns. Humans have evolved as social beings and are not innately programmed to deal with complete isolation situations. In fact, absolute isolation can have disastrous effects on the stability of human mind. So, although extensive lockdowns are the best we can do, we might have converted ourselves into lab rats for the world's biggest psychological experiment ever. Now, while medical research pushed limits to find a cure for COVID-19, the psychologists gauged the aftermath of these lockdowns. While some of us are just unhappy with the situation, the real problem is way beyond mere unpleasantries. Shortly before COVID-19 was declared a pandemic, The Lancet, a renowned medical journal, published a review of the psychological outcomes of this quarantine. You will find the link of this review in the description. The impact was estimated to be negative, pervasive, long-lasting, and mostly composed of post-traumatic stress disorders, PTSD, and other mental issues known to ensue out of confusion and anger. The triggers involved were not just isolation, but an interlinked web of all associated factors like boredom, frustration, loneliness, and beyond. Inadequate information, inadequate supplies, financial losses, fear of infection, stigma. Not just quarantine alone, but the duration for how long this quarantine exists also seemed to have profound impact on the outcome. The review also suggested certain policy considerations which the governments across the world could take up in minimizing the psychological impact on their people, like extending lockdowns only till it's absolutely necessary. Then providence of adequate supplies, adequate information, and other altruistic and kinder approaches. However, the havoc wreaking due to the collateral damage of the lockdown in other countries and especially in our country, it suggests otherwise. At individual levels, the stressors are gradually manifesting themselves. Due to absolute disruption of our daily schedules, we are all experiencing massive changes in our circadian rhythms. So, what are circadian rhythms? A circadian rhythm is a behavioral cycle that is induced upon us through daylight and darkness transitions which occur over the course of a day. This is controlled by a biological clock inside our brain. This clock runs a 24-hour cycle through each day and ensures our timely psychological urges like waking up in the morning, feeling sleepy at night, feeling hungry during lunch, feeling hungry during dinner. Nowadays, I'm sure many of you must be going through this. You wake up at some random time point and you have no idea what time of the day it is, what day it is and what is the date. So these are results of the disruption of this cycle, and the disruption is known to cause various mood disorders, insomnia, substance dependence, alongside other behavioral and psychological anomalies. Also, what is very worrisome is that cases of domestic violence, especially on children and women, and hate crimes have risen massively in the past few days. This can be traced to both the pandemic and the ensuing lockdown. The extended lockdown in India has caused a spike in the number of complaints received by the Indian National Commission of Women, of women being trapped with their abusers, with their tormentors. In India, there has also been an upsurge in communal content on social media platforms amidst these unfortunate times, which could also be fueling the rise in targeted violence towards certain communities. Mental illness is neither a necessary condition nor a sufficient trigger for violent activities or like for violence in general. However, scientific studies have found very strong correlations in the past. Last week, when the number of declared coronavirus infection cases crossed the 2.5 million mark, the death toll rose to 0.1 million, and countries around the world revised and relaxed and some toughened lockdown policies, Lancet Psychiatry published a position paper. You will find the link to the paper in the description of this video. It is a report on some exploration studies which the authors conducted on the social, psychological, and neuroscientific impacts of COVID-19. The paper discusses these impacts for different sections of the population. The young, the old, the children, the frontline healthcare workers, people in essential services, the differently abled, other vulnerable and excluded sections like the homeless, the refugees and prisoners. The paper calls for certain immediate actions which governments across the country should probably act upon immediately, and puts forward some long-term strategies to minimize the negative impacts of these lockdowns on the worldwide population. And these measures have been suggested by an interdisciplinary group of world-leading experts from the entire biopsychosocial spectrum. These include various monitoring methods and introduction of novel interventions to help people with coping mechanisms and to especially avert maladaptations. Because it has been predicted that these lockdowns might show a very bizarre impact in the later half of the century, as major absenteeism might creep into the world population. The authors have also emphasized upon further studies in similar directions. Now, why are these studies required? Why are these studies so important at this stage? The last pandemic which hit the human race at a large scale was the Spanish flu, which was in 1918. It's been 100 years since then. It was in the early 20th century. So now, let us compare it with the timeline of modern psychiatry. Modern psychiatry began to take preliminary shape in the early 20th century through the works of Sigmund Freud and Pierre Janet. But psychiatry as a clinical practice started in the later half of the 20th century. And this COVID-19 is the first pandemic of the 21st century. Psychoanalysts haven't really had a chance to understand psychological impact of pandemics on human population or understand the neurological basis of the trauma inflicted. The Scottish government has sanctioned extra funds towards mental health initiatives, especially for these unprecedented times. Scientists and clinicians across the world are providing information and resources over the internet to help people get through these difficult times. The editorial of the April 2020 issue of the scientific journal Anxiety and Depression has provided a link
to invaluable compilation of helpful resources from leading experts of the world, and it's for benefit of all and for dissemination, and it's available free. The website of Mental Health Foundation UK consists of more such information. The Indian government has launched a helpline for reaching out in collaboration with NIMHANS Bangalore. The World Health Organization calls health to be a fundamental human right, and it defines it as a state of complete physical, mental, and social well-being, and not merely the absence of disease or infirmity. Hence, while we go through these unforeseen times, let's ponder upon what the post-COVID times might be like. Will life as we know it cease to exist? Will this lead to a paradigm shift in the dynamic history of the human race? We will only know after these horrendous times come to an end, after the lockdowns are lifted. But do even more horrendous times await us at the end? You will find links to the papers I mentioned, the review paper, the position paper, in the description of this video. A few days back, I also did a more concise version of the same thing in Hindi. And if you're interested, you can take a look at it. The link is available in the description. And I also did an article on this, which has been published in the Science Communication magazine of our institute. The link is available in the description of this video. And well, the content is same, but if you have love for the written word, you might check it. Thank you for watching. If you liked the video, then please do subscribe to my channel and share the video. Thank you.